You know, military people always like to brag, you know, especially if they actually been into combat, you know. I just did an Army entertainment tour. I got so mad by the time I reached the third base. You know, the third base I visited, you know, every dude was like, "Hey, Colonel Jackson, Desert Storm, 1991, 92. You know, I'm like, "Okay, cool. I didn't ask you all that, but that's great." I had an answer for him, too. I was like, "Finesse Mitchell, Black Friday, Walmart, 2000. Old lady wouldn't give up the flat screen. I got this scar right here. Snatching that flat screen." And shout out to all the military people who have families, all you dads and moms out there, you know, serve your country, but you also, you know, raise a family. That is important, because I heard you get extra money in your check, right? Is that true? Yeah, and they give you better living quarters, right? Yeah. Nobody want to admit that, huh? Look at the brothers on the end. I got 9 kids. All of them ain't mine, but I'm living good on the base. Real good. I got free furniture. I'm a new dad. I'm 42, man. So if you're in your 40s and you have a baby, I found out I'm good at stuff I didn't even know I was good at. That's why I encourage all fellas to wait. You know what I mean? Because I didn't even know. I'm good at swaddling the baby. You know what swaddling is? That's when you wrap the baby up in such a way they can't get their arms out. You ever seen them presented on Facebook, the newborn babies? They have a look like a baby burrito. Little gay skull cap on. Yeah. I didn't even know I was good at that. The nurse was like, "Mr. Mitchell, I taught you how to swaddle one time, and now you do that better than all my nurses. How did you learn how to swaddle?" I was like, I've been wrapping this stuff up. Y'all can't see that in your car, but that was hilarious what I just did. Stitches, I wore them back. But now my daughter is 2. She's a tall 2. So, you know, my wife convinced me to convert the crib into a toddler bed by taking the front guardrail off of the crib. And that was a horrible idea. She was nervous because the baby kept putting her leg over the crib like she was going to jump out. And I was like, "She messing with you, babe. She would never do that." She's like, "Yeah, but we can't take a chance." And you know how fathers are. "Well, let her fall once. I think she do it once." But women don't agree with that philosophy. But I converted it, and horrible mistake. Because now the baby can get in and out of the bed whenever she wants to. You ever felt somebody staring at you in your sleep? You roll over at 4 in the morning, there's a creepy baby over the mattress just looking at you, saying creepy stuff, "Swiper, no swiping. Get away from me,